Oliver Cromwell and the English Republic. The King's army was defeated at the battles of Marston Moor and Naseby. By 1646, it was clear that the Parliament had won the war. Charles was held prisoner by the Parliamentary army. He was still unwilling to reach any agreement with the Parliament, and in 1649 he was executed. England declared itself a republic, called the Commonwealth. It no longer had a monarch. For a time, it was not totally clear how the country would be governed. For now, the army was in control. One of its generals, Oliver Cromwell, was sent to Ireland, where the revolt which had begun in 1641 still continued and where there was still a royalist army. Cromwell was successful in establishing the authority of the English Parliament, but did this with such violence that even today Cromwell remains a controversial figure in Ireland. The Scots had not agreed to the execution of Charles I and declared his son Charles II to be king. He was crowned King of Scotland and led a Scottish army into England. Cromwell defeated this army in the battles of Dunbar and Worcester. Charles II escaped from Worcester, famously hiding in an oak tree on one occasion, and eventually fled to Europe. Parliament now controlled Scotland as well as England and Wales. After his campaign in Ireland and victory over Charles II at Worcester, Cromwell was recognized as the leader of the new republic. He was given the title of Lord Protector and ruled until his death in 1658. When Cromwell died, his son, Richard, became Lord Protector in his place but was not able to control the army or the government. Although Britain had been a republic for 11 years, without Oliver Cromwell there was no clear leader or system of government. Many people in the country wanted stability. People began to talk about the need for a king.